actually going to kick off the quarterfinals of the Canadian Championship on May 7th right here. One Soccer is your home of the Can Champ, the quest for the Voyagers Cup. I want to talk first, though, about a certain game that's going to kick things off, gentlemen, at 11 a.m. ET. That'll be CF Montreal and Forge, as we know, meeting for the fourth time in the Canadian Championship. This was always on the schedule for the Canadian Premier League. This was always going to be a school day game. We know that pro teams have done this. The Toronto Blue Jays do this. The Toronto Marlies, the AHL affiliate of the Toronto Maple Leafs have done this for years. But of course, with the CAN Champ and the quarterfinals now falling next week, Canada Soccer has informed Forge that this is the only day Forge can play. Hence, we have an 11 a.m. TELUS Canadian Championship game. Pros and cons to a morning game. Jordo, take it away.
I'll talk about the cons first. I don't love the fact that we just celebrated such a cup set last week and Forge winning and all these things. And then in what world and what country and the next week you go and play? I understand that there's going to be a busy schedule this summer, all competitions. Could we get an extra week? Could we get 14 days to prepare or even 14 days to relish? 7 days to relish a CS St. Laurent, which this handsome man called, to go and give them some love before they go to BMO, before they host. Could we have a little separation next year? Look, there are so many good things we could talk about with the Canadian Championship, the fact that there are 14 teams. I don't want to be the person complaining. However, this is something where I would love a little space. So for whoever's listening, hear my cry. Space some things out so we can really enjoy the football. About the match specifically, because that's what you asked for, Andy Petrillo. I remember my last season playing for York United, 2022. Can't remember the team, but I remember the match was at 12 o'clock. It was hot. And everything about my routine was flipped on its head. I usually have oatmeal in the morning when I play a game, but it's usually a night game. So then I have a little pasta for lunch. And I don't want to get too specific, but basically I've relieved myself a couple of times, if you get my drift. Okay?
Yeah. Wonderful.
All right? So feeling light and feeling ready to go, ready to run a 12K. Specific enough. When you play at 11, ooh. I have to go and run in.
While yeah, tummy warming cramps.
Up, I said, oh boy, yeah, I forgot something in the locker room. Hey, forgot something. I have to go back and run in. What I'm trying to say is it throws your whole setup off.
We know what you're saying. I said I have to run boots on.
I have to run in for about 7 minutes, go get on my new pair of boots. You guys are with me.
About 7 minutes.
This is going to be a different time for the players. I think it favors Forge playing at home. See if Montreal coming in and they're not expecting a game like this. But I think for the diehard Forge fans, those I've spoken to, they're upset. They're at work. They're like, I can't get the day off. I want to be there to support my team. This is a game that they look for. See if Montreal has had Forge's number in the past. But they feel like this is the time to go and witness. And they want to see it. They're not going to go. Not all of them are going to go to CF Montreal and play the second leg. They want to be there at home and cheering. So I think it's great for the kids. I know this is going to be a day that was supposed to be the 500 Canadian Premier League match.
Yeah.
And they put supposed to play Halifax Wanderers. That was a great idea, and I think we need more of that. But to kind of, for Canada Soccer to use that as a time where you're going to play Canadian Championship, it's just odd. It's odd all over. Thanks for being with me, guys.
Yeah, well, and we completely understand. Many of us, we empathize for sure. But yeah, I mean, Ollie, and this is why, you know, the time was what it was. It was supposed to be a CPL match, and Canada Soccer kind of flexed their muscles and said, sorry, but this is the only day CF Montreal can play. And it's like, well, all right, I guess it's going to be at 11 a.m. I mean, what are your pros and cons to this?
Well, I mean, I'm trying to stay broadly positive, and it sounds like it's going to be a good crowd as a result of this kind of initiative that Forge have done with the school day match. So that's good. So there's going to be a lot of kids in the stadium. I'm sure many of them won't have been to a CPL game before, won't have been to see their local team before. And I'm always happy to see that. And that's something I think we should be doing more of. It is just unfortunate that it's, instead of being a league game, it is this Canadian Championship quarterfinal, and you kind of disrupt the supporters who are there every week a little bit. You disrupt the players, obviously, with the timing of the game as well. And I agree with what Jordan said. Firstly, like, I'm just bemused that we're playing Canadian Championship quarterfinals a few days after we played the preliminary round. Like, I don't really understand the need to do that when the semifinals are set for July and August. I get that Leagues Cup comes in am I happy about it? Not really, but I understand that, that's the reality. I know that you maybe want to avoid, you know, some big events for the national team that might overshadow this competition a little bit in the summer, but there still seems to be a bit of time in the calendar. I don't know, maybe there isn't. There's still, but it seems like it would be possible to you don't think so? I think over the next couple of months, it would seemingly be possible to me to play this game at a different time than 1 week after the preliminary round.
I get it, but look at the schedules for the MLS clubs. And whether we like it or not, they're big players in the Canadian Championship, and they're going to have a lot of say. This is going to require meticulous coordination between Canada Soccer, the MLS sides, the Canadian Premier League sides, and the League One sides going forward, that situations like this don't play out. Like, I hear you about the quick turnaround. That bothers me more than the timing of the game, because who works 9-to-5 jobs anyways these days? Unless you're like a teacher or work on the stock market. Who are these crazy people that decide to live their lives working 9-to-5 Monday to Friday?
I know. The grocery store is jammed no matter what time of day now.
Yeah. But you don't want it the week following. But look at the MLS schedules right now. CF Montreal, Toronto FC, and Vancouver Whitecaps play weekend, midweek, all the way through to the 1st of June. Then there's a little bit. There's 2 weeks off for the international window to be played. Then they play straight through Copa America. And right after Copa America, they play weekend, midweek, all the way through to Leagues Cup. It's Leagues Cup that has messed everything up for Canadian soccer fans, because it's probably a competition that they care least about on the balance of it. But American and Mexican supporters, like, it's a high value proposition for both Major League Soccer and company. Just look at the schedule. Like, it's crazy the way that it plays out. I've called games when I was play-by-play voice of the Raptors 905 in these daytime games. Like, there's a lot of people that show up, probably more than a regular game. And yeah, a lot of them are kids, but a lot of people do just take that time off to go and support their team. I commiserate. I feel bad for the people that can't do it, but unfortunately we live in an imperfect world here. And based upon how all the schedules play out, I just think it's a tough one. But like I said, unless you can start the League One and CPL seasons even earlier, which right now that's even testing, things won't change until that happens, unfortunately. So yeah, it's a difficult one.
Well, you're right. I've been to these school day games. They are loud.
They're fun.
They have not hit puberty yet. So it makes for a crazy kind of concert atmosphere.
Vuvuzelas.
It's like, no. But at a higher pitch. But yeah, I hope some of the diehards, because what you also start to think of is the gate, and you start to think of that revenue. So you hope that the others can really show up at, you know, at 11 a.m. if they can and fill that out. But it is really tough, and there's a lot going on in summer. And you are right. I've spoken to people at MLS Canada. The numbers for Leagues Cup in Canada, viewership, abysmal. So that kind of hoops Canadian soccer in many ways. But that game's at 11 a.m. We're going to be in studio for the 9 p.m. game. So you do have a couple games that are happening on May 7th. And I'm curious to know which is the more intriguing CPL versus MLS matchup for you tomorrow. Jordo, is it Forge versus CF Montreal or Cavalry and Whitecaps? Because all four of these clubs have history against each other.
I love them both. But before you say, and I think you guys are being a bit too mean to Ollie about him sitting on the fence. A lot of the times, I think he chooses a side. Sometimes he sits on the fence.
Debatable.
I will say, I think.
How long have you done this show for?
I think I sit on the fence new. Less than other people say I'm going to sit on the fence like Ollie does. That happens more
Speak
often.
Speak up, buddy.
Yeah, you have chain link burn on those cheeks. Let me tell you, you are sitting on that hard.
His Absolutely. Business card, Oliver Platt.
Anyway, great, Andy. Sorry to interrupt, Jordan. Please continue.
Chain link burn, love it. but no, that was class. But Forge, CF Montreal.
Don't get caught on that chain link.
Every year we talk about it. Do they have enough Forge to go and beat this team? I'm just looking for a fun affair. I think they can do it. I think that obviously tomorrow's match is huge and that start, but the depth within this Forge side, the way that they're playing promising football, I think this is coming at the right time. You could also mention CF Montreal and the injuries that they have within their squad right now. If there's a time to maybe, you know, give them a couple jabs, it is now. I like this matchup. I like what it brings. I like that they keep playing the same team. And hopefully, this is the Forge side or the CPL side that can actually get to a final in the Canadian Championship.
A lot of people feel that way about Calgary. I don't know. What are you looking at, Ollie?
I'm looking at Cavalry Whitecaps, and I think obviously this is the toughest team that Cavalry could have drawn. Whitecaps are the best team in the country at this point. I think most people would agree, but it's an interesting one for them because of the stretch they have coming up after this, before the second leg in Vancouver. They play LAFC, Colorado, and Seattle all on the road. At some point, this team is going to have to rest players like Brian White and Ryan Gold. I wonder if it's maybe this first leg against Cavalry where they just feel like they have no choice given some of the league games they have coming up, than to rotate the team. And this is somewhere still through two matches. And I know they weren't great in 2019, but they were better in 2022. They haven't actually won at ATCO Fields in Calgary before. So I think this first leg could be interesting and a bit of an opportunity potentially for Cavalry to get on the board.
Fence burn over there hit the nail on the head. Well done, Platt. It's not just the schedule build up around this first matchup, but the second leg is staged at BC Place between Vancouver and Calgary on May 21st. The game before that at Seattle, the game immediately following, Lionel Messi and Inter Miami come to Vancouver. So, I mean, those are two huge games for the Whitecaps. So how are they going to prepare? How are they going to, you know, kind of get this right for that stretch, which includes the Canadian Championship, which Vandy Sartini does say is a significant priority to go on and win this competition. I will remind you of the history between these clubs, Vancouver knocking out the Whitecaps in 2019. But in 2021, if Tommy Wheeldon Jr. listens to me this time around and puts a player on the far post defending corner kicks, then Calgary would have beat the Whitecaps instead of going to penalties that year as well. So they've been highly competitive. There's a lot of links between these clubs. We're in studio actually around this game tomorrow night. Even more reason to tune in.
Yeah, you know who you are with the like near post. You're like Ace Ventura, Pet Detective. Laces out, far post. Yeah.
Finkel and I know her. I'd heard of Finkel.
Laces out. Movie. I don't know. All right.
Funniest movie. I've ever seen in a theater.
Far post. That's all you keep yelling. All right, guys. With the first month of the